Hello everyone, welcome to YellowGreys. In this video, we will learn about exception handling in UiPath. When we develop our projects, there will be a chance to get an error in any activity of your workflow, right? That might be a selector exception, argument exception, null reference exception, or system exception, and so on. Now, we will learn how to handle such exception in our workflow. Here, I have a workflow which is already designed for a demo purpose. The workflow steps are: the bot will launch the browser and open the Amazon homepage. Then the bot will search the product name. Here I'm searching the product name as iPhone 13. Then click on the search button. Then the bot going to extract the iPhone product title, which is available on the first page, and also the product files. Then the bot will display all the extracted details in the message box. This is a process we created to show how to handle the exception. This workflow, which is not yet designed to handle any exceptions. Let me quickly run this workflow to show you how it works. Here, the UiPath is going to launch the web browser and it executes whatever the process steps we designed. The workflow ran successfully, but what if an exception occurs during the execution of the workflow? Let's say that for some reason the browser crashes during the launch due to an unavailable internet connection, or provide the incorrect URL of the web page, or the bot may failure any one of the activity due to unidentified the right selector, right? In such a case, what will happen? How you will handle these scenarios? In that case, the UiPath will throw an exception and it will terminate the workflow without executing the further steps. Now let me quickly run this project and one more time by providing the incorrect URL of the Amazon web page. Now run the workflow. So here you see the UiPath throw an exception says that source type into activity where error occurred and the message was could not find the UI element corresponding to this selector, and exception type is uipath.co.selector not found exception. Note this exception to handle the workflow. Now we come to explain the exception handling part. Go to the main workflow. Here, drag and drop try catch activity to handle the exception. The activity has three main sections: try, catches, and finally. Try calls the activity that could throw an exception. Catches specify the exception type and optionally hold an activity that informs the user about the found exception. Finally, hold an exception that should be executed only if no error occurred or if the error was already caught. Let's get started with this try block. This try block holds all the activity which are thrown to an error. Let me invoke the Amazon product search workflow into Drive block. Now, in case any exception occurs inside the try block, those exceptions will be handled inside the catches block. Let's look into the catches block. Here we have the option to add a new catch. Let's click on the exception drop down. Here we get a list of exceptions. You can choose the exception type. You can choose the exception type according to your exception scenario. Now, we know that we may face a selector exception in our workflow, right? Click on the exception dropdown and select browser for types. We already know that what kind of exception we received while running our workflow, right? So that is uipath.core.selector.not_found_exception. Search the same exception type here and click on select, then click OK. We specify the exception type. What is next? Optionally, we can add an activity that informs the user about the found exception. I will add a message box activity to show the output. Inside the message box activity, provide exception.message.toString to show the exception message. You can add log message or email activity that informs the user about the exception. And one more thing, you can add multiple exceptions in this catches section as well. Let's run the bot again to see the output. Now you can see that the bot ran completely without stopping and it caught the error and also it sent a message to the user about the exception. We have one more section here, that is finally. This section will be executed when the activity or set of activity to be performed after the try and the catches blocks are executed, or when an error occurs and it's caught in the catches section. Consider here what activity fits here to handle both the scenario, with exception and without exception. Obviously, we need to close the browser, right? In both the cases. Yes, I will add the close browser workflow into the finally section to close the browser in both the scenarios. Let me run the bot with the exception scenario. The bot execution happened with exception and finally the bot executed the closed browser workflow to close the open the browser. Again, I will run the bot without the exception scenario. The bot executed the entire workflow successfully and finally the bot executed the closed browser workflow to close the opened browser. I hope that you find this video useful for the exception handling part. Thank you for watching. Connect with us for more tutorials.